Did you know you can use peptides to help increase your muscle growth? In this video, I'm going to show you how my team and I helped a 58-year-old friend of mine gain an enormous amount of lean muscle tissue and muscle mass and lose dangerous visceral fat. So Bob is a 58-year-old entrepreneur. He's a friend of mine we met through Strategic Coach. And Bob set out to climb Mount Kilimanjaro in the last 2 years we've been working together. And if you've ever done any adventurous climbs like Kilimanjaro, you know it requires preparation before you actually get to the mountain. But Bob did it very successfully. And Bob, we saw him go from somebody who had quite a bit of visceral fat that he wanted to get rid of. He also had a lot of lethargy. He didn't have the spunk that he had when he was younger, and he wanted to regain that. He was somebody who had worked very hard, very successful in his enterprises, and he realized that his health was the next thing that he needed to focus on if he wanted to get his life to the next level. So what Bob did is when he presented in his diagnostics, we discovered in his blood labs, he had some metabolic issues. There is blood sugar, insulin resistant issues. We had to work on his liver, his kidneys, his gallbladder. We had to get all of his drainage systems functioning properly so that he could detoxify. Because what mistake most people make is they just go right into muscle building and they actually don't take care of the digestive system and all the detoxification so that you can clear out the waste. Because the first thing you want to do in any journey, and especially when it comes to building muscle, is you want to remove anything that would get in the way or interfere with your body's ability to break down the proteins. So we did a stool test. We found that we needed more enzymes, pancreatic enzymes. We also needed some bile salts so that he could emulsify the fats. And he noticed a big change in energy just by going through that simple detoxification process. The other thing that we found is that he did have a little bit of sarcopenia based on some of the markers in his labs, like his creatinine levels were lower than we anticipated. His protein levels were lower. And we realized that this is partially a product of having some insulin resistance, but we also realized that we've got to use two things to help him start building muscle now that his liver was working better. And so the first thing we did is we said, we've got to get more time under tension. And so for those of you who love the gym, you love lifting weights, you know time under tension is the time in which you put weight on your body, whether you're doing a squat. I did squats this morning, and so my legs are a little sore and shaky, but it was the time under tension. So going down nice and slow and coming up nice and slow. Ideally, you wanna go half the speed on the downward trend as you do the upward trend, or the eccentric versus the concentric. And what Bob started to do is spend more time actually lifting weights and slowing down the pace. Working with Nikki, our fitness trainer, he was able to get an enormous amount of benefits and even better amount of protection for his knees and other joints in his body just by slowing down the rate in which he was lifting weights. So this leads to what's called hypertrophy, which is a really fancy term for increasing your muscle volume and muscle mass. The other thing that you'll find is you start working on strength gains is you're going to have what's called proteostasis. And so muscle building requires proteostasis. And proteostasis is a term that means breaking down proteins. And if you look at the 12 hallmarks of aging, now there's like 16 and there'll be more coming down the pipeline. But the very first thing we realize is that as we age, we have this loss of proteostasis, which triggers sarcopenia. And sarcopenia is a dangerous condition where your muscles start to get replaced by fats. And so as Bob started lifting weights, he was able to reverse that trend of sarcopenia. And no matter what age you are, you can reverse this. I mean, this is where I love Charles Euster. If you hear stories about famous dentist who took up bodybuilding in his late 80s, and he was able to work with Mr. Olympia and put on 20 pounds of muscle in a short period of time as an 87-year-old. And then he took up sprinting in his 90s and he broke a bunch of world records. You know, by the age of 95, he was asked like, well, how do you feel about breaking all these world records in the 200 meter or the 100 meter? And he said, well, there's not a lot of competition in my age group, so I'm just happy I can run the distance. But those are things that we have to look forward to if we can start changing our body composition, because it's called the law of entropy. And I wish I could just, you know, magically make some of these physical laws disappear, but the laws of physics, you know, they're true. I mean, I like what Elon Musk says, is if it doesn't, violate the laws of physics, then we have to question all the requirements. But the law of entropy means that our bodies like to go to the most metabolically easy places possible. And holding on to muscle mass, if you think about the demands on your body, muscle mass is easier to live without it from just a survival perspective than to live with it from the law of entropy. But that's only if you want to die, you know, kind of miserable at a younger age. And if that's you, then you probably want to stop listening to this. But if you're like me and you're like, hey, I want to live as long as I possibly can with as much muscle health and as much physical fitness as possible, and then when it's my time to die, I want to die really fast, or ideally, like Brian Johnson says, don't die at all. I want to have really good muscle because it protects my joints, it allows me to move my body and participate in the physical activities that I want to participate in. And by building muscle, you need proteostasis. So the first thing you've got to do is you can't have a sedentary lifestyle. When we got Bob working out differently, he was already working out when we met with him, but he just changed his intensity and he changed his whole protocol and his intentions behind why he was working out. And that's what you can do too. So imagine that you've got this workout and this protocol that's very selective to you, and then you know exactly what you're doing every day to help change and transform your body so that the law of entropy doesn't come knocking at your door and cause sarcopenia. So first thing we did is weightlifting. And actually one of the studies on longevity, this was published in the Journal of Cell Biology and also in a journal called Circulation. But what they found is that just by exercising 400 to 6 minutes of moderate to low exercise every single week, your chances of reducing all-cause mortality are reversed by 26 to 31%. So there's no better therapy out there for your longevity than just to exercise. So that's the first criteria we had for Bob. And then the second thing we did is had him eat more protein. So when you eat protein, you are causing this proteostasis. So you're causing a breakdown of these proteins. As long as your stomach acids are where you want them to be, if you've got any acid reflux, or maybe you take omeprazole or some type of Tums or some kind of acid blocker, you want to do your best to get rid of those medications because they block your body's ability to break down proteins. And then you want to have your liver very, very healthy so that you can take those proteins and shuttle them into creating great muscle mass. So we got Bob eating proteins, approximately 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight, 6 days out of the week. We had him protein fast 1 day out of the week, and then we got him lifting weights, and it made a huge difference. But the thing that moved the needle the most, because he'd tried things like this in the past, like many of you have, is we got him on peptides. And there's some peptides that are really phenomenal that move the needle for Bob. One of those peptide stacks we got him on is called CJC1295. Now, many of you, you've heard me talk about these growth hormone releasing peptides, and CJC is very powerful, but there's one peptide that you want to bring in with it called ipamorelin. And what the studies show is that when you use ipamorelin with CJC1295, not only do you get a greater influx of growth hormone from your pituitary to the magnitude of 7 times greater, but you also don't get the hunger that can sometimes accompany the growth hormone releasing peptides or growth hormone secretagogues. And remember, these peptides are just little protein structures that turn on genes in your body so that your body actually starts making growth hormone on its own again. You also want to consider your recovery. Anytime you start a new exercise program, I know what it feels like when you got like the concrete in the legs. Sometimes it's called delayed onset muscle soreness. And so you want to make sure that you can recover from the exercising so that the next day you feel like working out again, or 2 days later. And so what we got him on is BPC-157 and thymosin beta-4. And these peptides are what we call the Wolverine stack. And it's a very popular peptide stack. But what BPC-157 does is it's angiogenic, so you get more nitric oxide, you get better blood circulation. The other thing that you'll find is you're going to have this greater level of recovery so you don't have the muscle soreness. So after 2 years, we ran Bob through a DEXA scan, And here's the results that I'm really excited about. So we had him on these peptide stacks and we got his body cleaned out. He was also doing some detoxification with CellCore, working on his micronutrient and hormone deficiencies. And what happened after 2 years is shocking. And I actually know this for a fact because I was at the same conference as he was. I was working out in the gym. He was on the treadmill and I didn't recognize it was Bob, even though I'd known him for 2 years. Because he looked like a different man. And then I saw him when he got off, I'm like, that was you. And his back looked muscly, his whole body composition changed. So Bob lost only 11 pounds, like 11.1 pounds. So you'd say, oh, that's not very impressive for 2 years. But here's the thing that happened that was the most important. His body fat reduction went from 34% down to 18.9%. His visceral fat loss, he lost over a pound of visceral fat. And his lean tissue, he gained 34 pounds of lean tissue and he lost 34 pounds of fat. So just think of that for a minute, like his whole body composition changed. And this is why you don't want to rely on a scale when it comes to, are you making progress in your current program? If Bob was able to lose, you know, 34 pounds of fat and gain 34 pounds of lean tissue, that's ideal because that's when he's really changing his body composition. He's telling the law of entropy, no thanks. I'm gonna keep building muscle. I'm gonna keep climbing Kilimanjaro or whatever his next adventure is. And that happened based on those three principles. He had great exercise, he had great nutrition, he had his detoxification in place, and then he had the right peptide structures. So if you're looking to use peptides to build muscle mass, there's a couple things that you want to do with peptides because you can't just out-peptide a sedentary lifestyle or poor nutrition. I wish you could. So by the end of this video, for those of you looking to gain more muscle mass and more muscle health, I'm going to show you the exact protocol we used to help Bob get there. I would be the world's fittest human because I take so many peptides, but I do the other things as well. So if you like this video, make sure you check out my next video, and I'm going to show you the exact stack that you can utilize to increase your muscle mass without having the inflammation. I'll see you there.